In this video, I'll show you how to make something swing like that. I have a scene set up here. Let's say I want to swing this sprite. What you can do is make a variable in, so float starts at 0. We're going to go to func process. We're going to increment n by delta each frame. And we're going to get sprite rotation. This rotation is going to be sine of n. You don't have to use delta. You can use any other random constant like 0.02 or something like that. I like to use delta. So there we have it. It swings around. But you want to adjust the frequency and amplitude and something like that. And to do that, export var frequency is a float, starts at 1. And we just multiply it inside this quotation here. So we can adjust the frequency to something like 20. That looks nice to me. So you might want to adjust the amplitude. Add a export amp. We're going to start at 0. And I'm going to limit the range to from 0 to half pi, which is 90 degrees. So you see nothing's going on right now. If I increase the amplitude, something is going on right now. Now you might want to adjust how fast it decays, because currently it just swings on forever. So we get export var decay. I'm just going to start at 0.9. And I'm going to add amount. Amount's going to be starting at 0. And amount is going to multiply to decay each frame. And we're going to get amount to the end of everything. And now nothing would happen because our amount is 0. This entire thing is 0. It's just not going to change the rotation. So what I'm going to do is if input is action just pressed, I'm going to use enter. So amount is 1. And you can see it swings around. But let's say I want it in many different places. Having 5 variables just cluttered up here is kind of annoying. So if you want it in many different places, you can abstract it away. So I'll call it swinger. I'm going to add a script. And I'm just going to copy all of these over. I'm going to say you call this swing function. And I'll make it swing, right? And if you want to get how much is swinging right now, we're going to get swing function. And it's just going to return this. So we can take this away. And now we can come back here, add our swinger object to it. And then we can take all of these away. So we're going to get our swinger. Swing. And the sprite2D rotation is swinger. Get swing. So nothing is happening right now. We're going to turn our amount up. And we're going to get our frequency to, I don't know, 20. There we go. And I suggest adding a range to the decay, because for decays like 0.5, it just decays so quickly. There's not much things going on. So I would suggest keeping this within maybe 0.9 to 1, 0.8 to 1. This is a more reasonable range. There you have it. Have fun. Make games.